We must lie flat on our backs and try to give our whole weight to the floor or the bed. The floor is better, for that does not yield in the least to us, and the bed does. Once on the floor, give way to it as far as possible. Every day you will become more sensitive to tension, and every day you will be better able to drop it. While you are flat on your backs, if you can find someone to prove your relaxation, so much the better. Let your friend lift an arm, bending it at the different joints, and then carefully lay it down. See if you can give its weight entirely to the other person, so that it seems to be no part of you, but as separate as if it were three bags of sand, fastened loosely at the wrist, the elbow, and the shoulder. It will then be full of life without tension. You will find, probably, either that you try to assist in raising the arm in your anxiety to make it heavy, or you will resist so that it is not heavy with its own weight, but with your personal effort. In some cases, the nervous force is so active that the arm reminds one of a lively eel. Then have your legs treated in the same way. It is good even to have someone throw your arm or your leg up and catch it, also to let it go unexpectedly. Unnecessary tension is proved when the limb, instead of dropping by the pure force of gravity, sticks fast wherever it was left. The remark, when the extended limb is brought to the attention of its owner, is, "Well, what did you want me to do? You did not say you wanted me to drop it," which shows the habitual attitude of tension so vividly as almost to be ridiculous. The very idea being, of course, that you are not wanted to do anything but let go. When the arm would drop of its own accord, if the person holding your arm says, "Now I will let go," and it must drop as if a dead weight, almost invariably it will not be the force of gravity that takes it down, but your own effort to make it a dead weight, and it will come down with a thump, which shows evident muscular effort, or so slowly and actively as to prove that you cannot let it alone. Constant and repeated trial, with right thought from the pupil, will be certain to bring good results, so that at least he or she can be sure of better power for rest in the limbs. Unfortunately, this first gain will not last, unless the work goes on. The legs and arms will soon be all tightened up again.